Rough Edges, the story of a family struggle against the ups and downs of life. Watch out for details.
Won't you sit?
No, sir. Thank you. I just came to tell you that I have resumed work.
You're welcome. You were released yesterday? Look, Lisa, what happened to you was terrible. It should not have happened. Things just went out of control.
You knew I was innocent, Chris.
Yes, Lisa, but there was nothing I could do. Management made the decisions. There was nothing I could do.
Then I went to the police cell because of you.
You should not have business. Fuck you.
Hey! You know how horrible that place is, don't you? And if you don't, I suggest you ask your wife.
Lisa? Well, I said I'm sorry.
That will be difficult, Chris. What was he doing here? Were your ears clogged with wax when I said I never wanted to see him here again?
I'm sorry, Auntie. He said he wanted to come and carry his child.
Which child? Haven't I told you CB is not his child?
I'm sorry.
Come. What else did he say?
He said you'll hear from his lawyer.
Stupid man.
Anything else but this.
I own you, remember? So you have to do it. Besides, it's nothing compared to going back to where you just came from. And this time, you just might not be able to send messages. About tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
Okay, right now.
Yes? Come in.
Good day, sir.
Yes. My secretary said you wanted to see me. Please, the management is really sorry about what happened. It was a huge mistake and we apologize profusely for it.
It's all right, sir. I appreciate your concern and it's okay. But sir, I am here on a very serious matter.
Did Mr. Sagi send you?
No, sir. Sir, I have a very sensitive information for you concerning the fraud case.
The fraud case?
Yes, sir.
Then sit down. Let me sit down.
This good man, good man. Good man, good man. Stingy fellow. Eat alone and die alone. Good man.
it's been quite some time.
Yeah,
I'm sorry I kept you waiting.
Oh, really?
We have some serious challenges in house. That's our business.
Yeah, it's all right.
Yes.
I understand.
Yes, anyway.
I understand.
I am somewhat pressed for time today. I don't know
How we are going to?
I need your help badly.
Is anything the matter?
It's Mabel.
Mabel?
She has fibroid. The doctor said they have to operate on her immediately or she will lose her womb. We desperately need 300,000 naira.
This must have been very trying for the both of you. Now, look, I can arrange for her to come to the bank's hospital today, yes. We have to move fast about the surgery.
No, you see, we already registered her in another hospital. And, you know, it's better that she goes to a place where, you know, she's already known.
But I don't think it is wise for us to spend that kind of money. Listen, Nadozie, I'm entitled to about 500,000 naira worth of Medicare in the bank's hospital. Let us bring her here. That will leave us with some money to take care of her recuperation.
That's true. But you see, those people have her medical records. In case of complications, it's better for her to go where she's known.
No, listen, Dozie, we have capable hands here.
Can you not give me the money?
Just keep.
I mean, we need the money.
I see.
We need it. We need it.
Dozie, why are you coming to borrow 300,000 naira from me? These are peanuts to you. Not so. Now tell me, what happened to the 4 million naira investment?
It's there. You know, these things, they take time. It takes time. It's there.
I don't really think Mabel is sick. You want to give the money to those fraudsters, don't you?
Something, Nina. Is there something about me that looks foolish to you? I have been speaking to the wrong people.
Absolutely sure of what you are telling me?
Absolutely, sir. And sir, maybe when you go through that document, you'll be very certain as I am.
I hope to God that you are absolutely correct in what you are saying.
I am, sir.
What you mean?
Nadozie. We have been friends for a long time.
Yes.
I must warn you, you are risking everything.
Chris, I need the money for my wife. And that is all.
Okay. Should I call Mabel now?
Sorry, but Chris, the business is legal. I will get the money any day now. Any day now. Any day now.
I don't know how else I'm going to convince you. I'm not going to give you any money to give to those fraudsters.
Chris!
What?
It's better you make friends with snakes. Those guys are crooks. I'm not giving you any money to give to them.
Then eat it! Keep it! I don't need you anyway!
What is This is
a racist. How dare you talk to me like that?
Please, this is a
racist. I told my friends.
People are
I can't believe what you're doing to me here. Do you know how much I made this money? How dare you?
Amen.
Right.
Sir.
I've told you, relax and enjoy yourself. From today and henceforth, you will eat from this table. Is that understood?
Yes, sir. I'm very glad to be honored, sir.
It is not an honor. You have earned it.
Thank you, sir.
Now that the court hearing is coming up tomorrow, I hope to hold strongly to your words.
Absolutely. I am as certain as daylight that your wife is coming to this house tomorrow.
In fact, three of you should stay home, right? We have enemies everywhere. And leaving the home unattended to in a day when they know we will not be at home, that's not wise. So you guys should stay at home. Tell your auntie I won't be able to come back to pick her. She'll meet me in the court.
But I want to be there, Dad.
Me too.
Then listen, two of you should stay at home, okay? I promise you your mother is coming back today. By the way, where is Princess?
She's not in the house.
What?
She left early.
To where?
I wouldn't know.
What's my father's name doing on a file in your room?
Where did you get that?
Here on the table, of course.
Why are you snooping around? Huh?
I don't even know what you're talking about. Can I just get a moment to take a shower,
You don't know what I'm talking about, and I'm not saying now!
Let's say, your dad and I work in the same bank.
What? And you kept this away from me all this while?
I really thought if I had told you from the start, you wouldn't go out with me, and that's the bottom line truth.
Besides, this is just a regular file. It's nothing to bug your head over.
Come on, give it to me.
Everything to your satisfaction, G?
Couldn't have been better. You've done your miracle work again. Now tell me, in which heaven did you get this curse?
Let that be my headache, Chief. You just concentrate on enjoying yourself. Come, there's someone I reserve especially for you.
Shall I understand?
That is easy. Throw your hands in the air.
Raise the roof.
Come on.
Raise the roof.
Every time I hit the show, everybody lose control. Free your mind and free your soul. Let the music take control. It's a party. My shaky body.
Bambe. I don't have to explain my reasons. Somebody tell me this is not happening.
What are you talking about?
You're in love. The great Auntie Sharon. In love? And with a smooth operator like Ambe?
Shut up, you slut. How dare you, princess?
Mm-hmm. It's sad to see an old horse try to win a race she can no longer run.
Jenkins, that bitch won't allow me take my daughter. She even carries a gun now.
A gun?
The whole place was crawling with hookers. She threatened to shoot me if I don't let go of Sibley.
Okay, now listen, I didn't know you had gotten to this point, okay? But that's serious.
I can't allow my daughter to be raised up in a brothel.
Okay, now listen, I'm going to institute proceedings immediately. But I need you to keep calm, okay? You got to keep calm so that I could take care of that angle.
Okay, you better act fast before I take the laws into my hand.
Please, just keep calm, okay? Okay, thanks. I'll see you now. I'll see you later. Thanks, eh?
All right, then.
My God.
You wanted me, sir?
What is it, sir?
You remember me?
Yes, of course I do. What can I do for you?
My subordinates are downstairs. You'll have to come with us.
Come with you to work.
Mr. Asage, I am disappointed in you. I trusted you.
Sir, I don't understand what you're talking about.
You are under arrest.
Rough Edges, the story of a family struggle against the ups and downs of life. Watch out for details.